Hi, I'm Paul Denmen. I'm the Director of Business Development for North America for Nippon Pulse.
I'm Wyatt, and we are currently here in the R&D lab at KEB America. I'm going to be showing off how our S6 drive can be used to communicate with a linear motor using our software CombiViz 6. A linear motor is different from a rotary motor in its construction. So in a rotary motor, the stator has a rotor sitting inside of it that rotates to produce torque. In a linear motor, the stator is unfurled and the rotor sits on top of it and moves to produce linear force.
We're going to exhibit a KEB drive running with a linear shaft motor that Nippon Pulse manufactures. Fundamentally, the shaft motor is a brushless DC motor. It's a three-phase motor that looks like, to another driver controller, a standard rotary brushless DC motor. There's basically three wires coming out of the coil, which is a Y configuration. And it only involves hooking it up and tuning it as you normally would any other brushless DC motor. The motor is made up of some very fundamental things. A shaft, which is stainless steel that has round donut magnets in it, and a coil that is in what's called a forcer. It's a rectangular area where the coils with no iron are based around it. Now, the advantage to shaft motors is that they utilize 360 degrees, or 100% of the magnetic force of the magnets, as compared to flat linear motors, where you're only seeing the surface area of a magnet. Here you're getting the Faraday principle of looking at all the magnetic field of the motor. So applications for a linear shaft motor vary tremendously. They're fast, they're very accurate, and they're very power efficient. So when you have those combinations, you find yourself into a lot of different areas. So in the more accurate areas, semiconductor and some medical applications, DNA sequencing, genotyping, those kind of things. In the area of semi-accurate, commercial or industrial, you want a lot of force, but you want to move very quickly. For example, this motor is being used in a bread factory to load 300-pound bags of flour in a cook oven. The same motor is used at Intel on a wafer application. The motor is only as accurate as the encoder. This motor has the ability to move very precisely, not only because of the encoder, but also because it's non-cogging. Basically, if you take a power tool or something with a brushless DC motor, you can tell the motor is grabbing in position. You don't want that when you're moving very precisely over an area and the servo is trying to compensate for that pull or variation. So a noise-free motor, in this case, magnetic noise-free, the linear motions are very critical. Non-cogging is important. Today, this is showing a product working with a KEB America drive. Different from a PID loop, a VFD is changing the frequency it's modulating to the motor coil. It involves a product that's called an SLP stage by Nippon Pulse. The encoder actually is just like a standard encoder. This one's linear, it's an index encoder that gives you position feedback, just like perhaps a rotary encoder on a brushless DC motor. The new trend in the market today is what's called edge analytics. It's an application where you're analyzing a data electronically from an actuator on a production line. So when you have an application where you can have a possible hydraulic or pneumatic actuator fail and you're on a automotive assembly line, you're losing about $60,000 to $70,000 per minute while that line is down. So this is why there's an area where high power applications or critical power applications are important to convert to electrical.
If you have a linear motor application and you would like to know more about how KEB can help you engineer a solution, feel free to reach out and contact an application engineer like myself.